Hey everyone, it's Katrina Sawa here, the Jumpstart Your Biz Coach with jumpstartyourbiznow.com and Jumpstart Publishing. And I think I was already live, but it's Katrina Sawa here with jumpstartyourbiznow.com. And I want to do a quick live today because I've been on a few different calls lately on Zoom where there's like hundreds of speakers. And I run an international speaker network, in case you didn't know. But there's a lot of talk about coming back to live events and what kind of like getting paid to speak. And I wanted to address a few things because I think there's a lot of people out there that haven't really spoken a lot who are entrepreneurs or newer entrepreneurs who need to know the lay of the land in this speaking world, especially post or during pandemic, right? So there's three ways to speak usually as a speaker and an entrepreneur. There's the free speaker, which is where we speak for free and give great content and then hopes that people will want to connect with us in the back of the room, or we drive them to say a free thing on our website, or we can even make a paid offer depending on where we're speaking. So it's speaking for free, which is a marketing strategy. Then there's the paid speaking, right? Where we get paid to speak. Someone says, I want to book you as my keynote, or I want to book you to speak to my employees. And that could be hundreds, it could be thousands of dollars, right? And everybody seems to want that, although they don't understand that those are a little bit fewer and far between opportunities that are, you know, that aren't necessarily handed out as easily. So, but nonetheless, it's still good to have a price for your talk and your keynote, or how much you're going to charge for your time. I've been paid to speak, but I prefer the free speaking myself because I can control then the lead generation in the back of the room. When you're paid to speak, then most people, you don't sell anything because you're already getting paid. So usually just giving your stuff, and maybe you can offer your books in the back of the room or whatnot, especially in person. They might pre-buy your books or your materials as well when they pay you to speak. So there's that. And then there's the pay-to-play. The pay-to-play speaking opportunity. I've talked with at least a handful of people who are maybe newer to the entrepreneur speaking world who are appalled at the fact that, yeah, we're going to charge you to speak. You can speak here if you pay to speak. But I'm telling you, if you put the right group together, I will pay you a lot of money to speak in front of your audience. I've paid up to $3,500, which isn't that much, honestly, when it comes to this, but I paid up to $3,500 to speak to a group of my ideal clients, 300 people in the room that I would not have been able to get in the room and to speak in front of, frankly, and it was worth it because I've made probably $60,000 or $70,000 in the follow-up and in the ongoing marketing after meeting the people there and working with them over time or talking to them over time. And it's probably more than that. It's just on the top of my head. That's what I'm thinking. I paid $5,000 for a booth and sponsorship. I have friends that have paid anywhere from $10,000 to $50,000 to be on a stage before. And then there's all the online stages, right? The online summits, the online gift giveaways. And those are usually anywhere from, maybe $50 to, I've seen them as high as maybe $500 or $600 for one opportunity like that. And if the person who's running it is a good marketer and you know that they have a pretty good following and they're bringing a good group of speakers who have good followings, then that could be definitely a good opportunity as well. I've done multiple paid online summit speaker fees and speaker opportunities, as well as online giveaways where you don't speak, you just give a free gift. I mean, I've gotten up to 400 people on my email list from some of those opportunities where I might have paid a couple $100 to get 400 people on my email list. It takes a while to get 400 people on your email list. So that's, again, another good investment. Now, that's an advertising strategy. So the free speaking is a marketing strategy. So you want to treat it as marketing for lead generation. Then the paid speaking is a business model. It's just like anything else that you're selling. You're selling consulting, you're selling coaching, you're selling a group program or an online course, you're selling yourself as a speaker. It's a business model, okay? And then there's the pay to play, which is a marketing or advertising strategy. And sometimes you should and sometimes you shouldn't, it depends. So I just wanted to kind of outline that a little bit because I think there's people out in the world, because I run across a lot of speakers. I have over 2,800 people in my speaker network and we have a Facebook group and I hear a lot of things and there's a lot of buzz. And so I just wanted to dispel the myths that any one of those are bad. I would take a free speaking gig all day long. And even if it's, I mean, one of the smallest speaking gigs I had was to three people. There was four of us in the room. Meaning one of, no, I think there was four people in the room besides myself. And one was the gal who booked me. One was already one of my clients who showed up. And all the other three that weren't already a client became a client of some sort during that. And I had no idea. I could have, it was a 2-hour drive one way. So 4 hours in the car to talk to four people, three of which were not clients. Most people would have canceled, but I think I made $7,500 that day from the people who bought my stuff in the back of the room. I'm just telling you, like, speaking can be the fastest path to cash. You can make money on the spot when you're speaking. You can also make a lot of money in the follow-up if you have the right strategies, systems, and automation and follow-up. Most people are horrible at that. If you come to a speaking gig, they try to get whatever they can, and then anybody else is just gonna be like, they don't do much with you after that. I'm telling you, this is one of the biggest reasons I've made tens of thousands of dollars from free speaking gigs and paid speaking gigs is because of my follow-up and the organization in which I keep my database and how I run all those follow-up nurturing sequences. I do direct mail, I do email, I do phone calls, and I do private messages on social media. I'm telling you, you can do this, and this can be your main marketing strategy if you do these things well. If you do them not so well, then you might be spending a lot of time and not seeing a lot of results, and we don't want that. So I happen to be hosting a call tomorrow morning, Friday the 14th of January, from 9 to 10 a.m. Pacific. And it's sharing information on one of my online summits that I'm doing in February. So I am looking for speakers for that. But I think you'll learn a lot in general if you're interested in speaking. And you can come to that. I'll be inviting people to my international speaker network calls, which is the following Friday, same time. And those are free calls, but the call tomorrow is free as well. You just need to go to that. Well, I'll put the link in the comments below, but you need to comment and say like, hey, I want more speaking gigs. If you want more speaking gigs, I know where to get you speaking gigs. People that apply for my stuff are on my radar now. So I know who speaks on what topics, and I get asked all the time for speakers. I was just asked to fill in on a speaking gig for the 18th in person next Tuesday, I want to say. And I could have like referred somebody else, but I made it work for me to attend. But that happens to me all the time. I need a speaker and I'm in Colorado. Oh, okay. I know who to refer to you. I need a speaker and I'm in San Diego. Oh, okay. I have someone that I can refer to you. So you want to be on my radar. You want to share with me what you're speaking about. You want to make sure I know who you are so that I can refer you or book you myself because I'm looking for, I have at least 60 or 70 speaking slots to fill this year alone, if not more, because I'm also going to be having a whole in-person conference for speakers in Dallas this summer too. So I'm telling you, now is the time to get connected to me. And because I want to help. I want to help you get booked more, hone your speaking skills. I want to help you, excuse me, make money from your speaking. And yeah, so there you go. Speak more, speak often. Let's do it. I'll talk to you soon, okay? Comment below if you're interested in any of this and so I can private message you because otherwise I don't know if you're interested. So have a good day, everyone.